This is Super Mario Land 2, and we just came out from inside a whale that was inside a turtle. And we have 4 zones to go. But first, I think I should spend some of these coins. I have 474. Of course, the question is, do I want to save up until I have 999 and see what I get? I mean, I'm assuming it's just going to be another slot machine, but like, maybe there's a chance to win like 50 extra lives or something. Or I could do this one twice, or I could do this one 8 times, 9 times, I'm good at math. I don't know, I kind of want to save up. It's tempting. I think I'll hold on to him though. Because if not now, then when? You know? Because if I spend these, if I spend what I have, I didn't mean to go here, then I'm probably not going to save up this many again. So, good to hold on to what I have for now. I didn't mean to go up here either. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know where the zones are. I haven't even decided what I'm going to next. Okay, this is Macro Zone, which I'm assuming is going to be like Big World in Super Mario Bros. 3, which should be awesome. So I want to save that one. Pumpkin Zone. That sounds good. There's a witch flying around and tombstones. You know, I don't know if Pumpkin Zone is the most accurate thing to call this. I mean, yes, it is inside a pumpkin, but there's more going on here than just gourds. That thing is adorable! I love it! Well, I feel bad about killing it. That'd be a good slogan for a store called the Pumpkin Zone, but they also sell other things besides pumpkins. Their slogan could be, "We're more than just gourds. Come down to Pumpkin Zone." I don't know what else they would sell at Pumpkin Zone. Maybe it's like Auto Zone, and that's where you take to have your pumpkin repaired, you know, change its oil. They open it up, scoop out the seeds. Those seeds are bad, man. This pumpkin needs new seeds. When was the last time you changed the seeds in this thing? I don't know. I don't think I ever changed the seeds in it. Jesus, dude! This pumpkin is not gonna last if you do not bring it back to Pumpkin Zone for regular maintenance. Wait, you cut a face into your pumpkin? That is not going to be good for its resale value. If you didn't cut the face into this pumpkin, Blue Book value, you get at least a couple dollars for it. Now, it's garbage. No one's going to want that after Halloween. You were not thinking about the future of your pumpkin investment, my friend. Hey, it's Booze! Aww. I got so excited about the booze that I wanted to give them a hug. But they don't like hugs. They're too shy for hugs. Well, that was a detour. I guess it was worth it. We got a 1-up, even though I lost my power-up. I think my favorite part of those walking Splatterhouse masks is the dagger sticking out of it. It's just, oh, don't mind me. This is just my dagger. You know what happens when a Jason mask starts growing its first dagger? That's when it becomes a man. Well. I could just forget about the bonus game, but it looks like it's going to be pretty easy to get. Whoa! Oh. Very clever game. That thing looks like Jack Frost, kind of. The Shin Megami Tensei / Persona mascot. Only with a crazy awesome hairdo. I bet I'm gonna get this momentum wrong again. I don't know, I actually got it. Alright, conveyor belt. Any of these things will be useful for me, since I don't have a power-up now. I mean, I have plenty of lives, so it's not really imperative. Oh, okay. Three more. We're back to a four-level stage instead of just a three-level stage. Like that crappy Turtle Zone. I shouldn't say that. Turtle Zone was pretty cool. Whoa. It's one of those Japanese umbrella monsters. I think this one actually is Japanese. Unlike the hopping zombie that is actually a Chinese monster that I misidentified as a Japanese monster. Whoa. They look like the statues. Well, sort of. They look sort of like the Bowser statues at the end of Super Mario 3. Whoa. I think I just passed over a bunch of the level. I don't know if that's good or not. Aw, man. Well, as is tradition, when I die, I'll try taking the other path now and see if I don't die. Even though the point I died was where the paths met anyway. Where they undiverged. Aw, man. Man, this game's mean. Oh well. At least I got a mushroom out of it. So apparently, I was doing a little bit of research on the Mario Wiki. Because, you know, that's how cool people spend their Saturday nights. And the setting of Super Mario Land is actually, like, a place. Like, there's a description of it. I guess the description comes from the manual. But it's called Sarsara Land? Sarsara Land? That's probably way off. Something along those lines. And each of the areas in that place are, like, named locations in Mario canon, which I thought was kind of weird. So if that was a place, Super Mario Land is actually, like, canon. You know, if those locations are canon, then what the hell is all this? Are these locations canon as well? Is this a different part of Sarsara Land? Whoa, what? You're not supposed to be able to break these like that. That is so weird. Well, maybe I don't know if I ever actually tried to break those in this game. So maybe you can't. Well, no, I did break them with a spin jump earlier, like on level 1. So I guess it makes sense that you can break it with your head as well. Come on, Star. See, it's punishing me because in Mario Land 1. I complained about the star going way off the screen and being hard to get. And in this game, the star doesn't move at all. So it's ironic punishment. It's like, oops. It's like punishing me for smoking by making me smoke the whole pack. Except it's not like that at all. It would be pretty messed up if anyone ever actually did that. Like, was that just a Looney Tunes thing? Or did people actually do that back in the 50s? Catch their kids smoking and make them smoke the whole pack? Because, A, I don't think it would help. I mean, yeah, they get sick that one time. But overall, I don't think it would curb their smoking. And B, I mean, that would be really dangerous for, like, a young kid. I hope nobody ever actually did that. If you're a parent watching this and you catch your kid smoking, please don't make them smoke the whole pack. That is not cool. Also, if there are any parents watching this, my heart goes out to you. Now, the music, it's like a remix of the underground music from Mario Land 1. That's kind of cool. I didn't realize this game had any connection. Well, I mean, it might not. This might just be a... Well, that answers that question. I mean, this might just be a random callback. But yeah, it's kind of weird how this game shares almost nothing in common with Mario Land. Like, they were trying to distance themselves from that as much as they could. Except for this music. Also, those Goomba Boos are pretty cool. Oh yeah, I can't spin jump when I'm small. I have to say, it's not as good as the Ghost House music from Mario World. I mean, I know this isn't technically a Ghost House in the Mario World sense, but yeah, it leaves a little bit to be desired. I'm kind of getting the hang of the controls in this game. Man, I really want to see what's in the rest of these boxes. Ah. I'm glad I persisted. That's going to be helpful. I think I like the bunny ears better now that I know you can just hold it to float. Although you do have to remember to press jump again in the air. I guess it's more like the... Well, no. I'm gonna say it's more like the Yoshi float, but you don't have to press it again in the air. Oh no. I can't tell if this is a safe way to go or not. Well, it's safe, but there's no reason to come down here. Aw man, I knew that was gonna happen. Curse you, tiny screen real estate. Yeah, I guess come to think of it, there haven't been any of the typical brick-style blocks in this game. So I guess the... I guess the closed-eye style block, well, the friendly closed-eye style block is the breakable one in this game. Well, now that I have flour, I can... Oh, one up. Nice. See, I'm glad it does come out of the top of the block when you do that, not the bottom. I mean, I still would have been able to get it, but... It's good to know that for future reference. See, this is a nice kind of disappearing block. Because it doesn't actually disappear, you can still stand on it. You just can't see it. I don't know, I do like this tune. Like this cool, minimalistic remix of it. But it's not really appropriate for this kind of level, I don't think. I don't know, maybe it is, what do I know? Alright, minigame. Well, I guess there's no reason not to go for 3 extra lives. Or at least try to. Alright. Three up. So I wonder if the witch is the boss, or if she's just kind of floating around. I was surprised by the boss in the last zone. So I might be... Well, are those gonna... No, I thought they were gonna be the Mario 3 candles that come to life. That looks like it should be 4 something. Man, Mario 3 was so good. I know I talk about Mario 3 a lot. That's my favorite Mario game. That was my favorite game. Mario 3 was just so... just a perfect game. I am liking this, though, because it reminds me a lot of Mario 3, actually. Just in the level design and how much weird stuff there is. Although the levels are much bigger than Mario 3 levels. See, that looks like the brick style block from every other Mario game, but it doesn't appear to be breakable. Sure, why not? Bets on whether that thing breaks into multiple brooms. Nope. Man, that would be cool if it did. That was a missed opportunity. Nope, just a broom. Just a random broom that kicked my ass. Whoa. Some sort of specimen in those jars. Ah, what? I jumped on that thing. BS, man. What is that? It looks like a... is that a blooper? Looks kind of like a blooper in a bottle. A bottle of blooper. Bloopers are the squid-like enemies. One of the few enemies for which I actually know the name. This game has a lot of enemy types. I wonder if they're all listed in the manual. I don't know if you heard, but I snapped in frustration. That's my reaction. I snap. Not like snap and go crazy, but I snap my fingers. I really like this game so far. I think it might be, if the quality holds up, it might be in my top 5 Mario games. Crap, I have to say what they are now, don't I? Okay, well, take this with a grain of salt. This is just my opinion. This isn't what I think the best Mario games are. These are just my personal favorites. Top 5. Don't start any arguments over this. It's just video games, don't get mad. Number 1, Super Mario Bros. 3, of course. Possibly the best game ever made. Number 2, Yoshi's Island. I like Yoshi's Island a lot. You can watch me play it in its entirety on my YouTube channel. Number 3, Super Mario World. Also a very good game. Not as good as Mario 3, as, you know, a lot of people think Mario World is better than Mario 3. It's very good, but it's not as good. My opinion. Number 4, Super Mario Bros. 2. Number 5, probably this game. Oh, it is a witch. Nice. Wow, a lot of slowdown here. Whoa, oh man. I didn't see the spikes up there. But yeah, before I play this, my number 5 would probably be Mario 3D Land on the 3DS. But this is really good. Is that like a bird witch? Is that a beak? Or just a weird looking face? I don't know. So yeah, there's my top 5. Don't judge me for it. Nice. Okay, so what do I have left? I have Mario Land, or Mario Zone rather. Macro Zone. And what else? There's one more. I want to save Mario Zone, I want to save Macro Zone. Man, it's going to take me a while to get 999 coins too. I'm missing something somewhere. Maybe once I get the fifth coin, like, it unlocks a different area where I go to get the sixth coin. I don't know. Oh well, I'll figure it out later. This has been Let's Play Super Mario Land. I've had fun. I hope you've had fun too. It's been cool discovering this game along with everyone here. Except the people who are already familiar with it, of course. So yeah, that'll do it. Tune in next time for more Super Mario Land 2, 6 Golden Coins. Goodbye.